Hello, my name is Chris McCullough, and I am Director of Evangelization and Faith Formation at the Cathedral of Mary, our Queen. Today is Tuesday in this fifth week of Lent. I thank you for joining us for this reflection during Lent. For the remainder of this week, we will read from John's Gospel, which will lead up to the events of Palm Sunday. In these readings, we will hear tension build up between Jesus and the Jewish leadership. We will also hear more and more people come to believe in Jesus because of his teaching, but the Jewish leadership will become more and more uncomfortable with him. They become uncomfortable in part because of Jesus's following, but more importantly, because of how Jesus describes who he is. It troubles them because it challenges their understanding of who God is. It all sounds a bit blasphemous to them, and in the end, they decide that Jesus must be killed. The setting for this part of John's Gospel is the Feast of Tabernacles, which is a time when our Jewish brothers and sisters remember how they lived in the desert for 40 years during the Exodus. It is also a time of remembering God's provision for them during this time in the desert. As a part of this week-long celebration, they would pitch tents and they would live in them for the week. What John is recalling in this setting of the feast is the memory of God's provision for the Israelites. John wishes to portray Jesus as the new provider. Jesus is now the dispenser of living water. Jesus is now the light of the world. Jesus is now the great I am. Jesus's claim to be I am confounds the Jewish leadership, and thus their concern about Jesus grows. In the context of making the claim I am, Jesus also speaks of being lifted up. In the context of the feast, it refers to a time when God instructed Moses to put a gold serpent on a staff so that the Israelites who were ill could be healed. Here in John, it is also a reference to Jesus being lifted up on the cross. For John, being lifted up on the cross is the moment of Jesus' glory. It not only includes the crucifixion, but it also includes the resurrection and the ascension into heaven. For John, it is all the same moment. And in that moment, God reveals Jesus' true nature as the Son of God. As we travel through this fifth week of Lent, let us ask ourselves, as Jesus spoke in John's Gospel, how does God speak to us? Can we use this time to reflect on all that God has done for us? How is God, the great I am, the provider of all that we need? What of God's provision in our lives informs, shapes, and enlivens our faith? And let us pray. Dear God, the great I am, provide for us all that we need in this day. May we discover you active and present in our lives by your provision for us. May we see your good works and give you praise for all that you have lifted up for us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember that we celebrate Mass here daily at 7 and 8:15 in the morning and again at 5:30 in the afternoon. And if you cannot join us for any of these liturgies, please watch our live stream online. We live stream the 8:15 Mass, and you can find it by going to our webpage and clicking on the Watch Mass Live button. We thank you for being with us for this reflection, and have a blessed day.